As I gaze into the eyes of the man they call Prince, I see not a ruler, but a puppet, a pawn, manipulated since birth by courtiers, friends, family, and even gods. Their admonitions pull me in all directions, tearing me apart, breaking me. I see a man who yearns for righteousness, but knows not who he must become. I will assert my power. My enemies will know my wrath. My resolve will never falter. My empire will prosper, and all those who stand in my way will be swept aside. I will be cautious and observant. I will plan meticulously, leveraging my connections. I will plot, scheme, and turn unsuspecting foes into friends. My courtiers will slit each other's throats to win my favor. I will listen to the people and heed their will. I will rule for their sake. I will strive for the greater good and the prosperity of all. I will cherish those I hold dear, guided by love and compassion. I will be the ruling hand of the gods. I will make their will manifest, and those who dare question my faith will draw their righteous ire. True believers will know love and bliss. My empire will become heaven on earth. And I will lead my flock to a brave new world. As I plumb the depths of my soul, I find a singular truth within. No matter the path I take, my life will be full of pain and suffering. Such is the fate of all rulers.
Hi, my name is Fedor. I'm the founder of Schisma Games. We made the life and suffering of Seb Branter. Right now, we have a new project in the works, and we want to tell you all about it. We took on a new project because we saw it as a challenge. We like making our genre deeper, experimenting with it, finding new heroes in new circumstances.
First of all, this game is a completely new story. It will revolve around a new character, and the people around him will be quite different. But here's the crucial part. You'll play a new role in the world of Talisman. It has its own peculiar problems, its own trials and tribulations.
Our new hero, whose place you will assume in the game, is His Highness Prince Jarian, heir to the blessed Arknian Empire.
In the previous game, our hero was a backwater commoner. This time, we're making a complete 180. You'll be looking from the top down, through the eyes of the Prince of the blessed Arknian Empire. You will face great trials, make decisions, and endure the suffering of the lords of the land. And his fate, our hero's fate, will be decided by powers both political and societal, as well as player's choice, naturally.
Our hero is Prince Jarian. He's looking through a manuscript that he penned throughout the course of his life. As he reads, he often gets very emotional. Sometimes he's uplifted, sometimes he's surprised. But in the end, much of his story is suffering. We want players to feel for our hero, to rejoice and suffer with him. You'll see Jarian go through life, enter into adulthood, and have adventures. The Empire itself will be another main character. It has traditions, customs, and distinctive traits.
At a glance, our game may seem like an interactive book. That's not quite right. Underneath, there is an intricate network of character interactivity, and an entire system of state, and the classes that comprise it.
Gods are real and cruel. This is their world, where everyone gets their lot, their path, and their punishment. The world is torn apart by vicious social struggles, whose roots run deeper than politics or history. Should this world fail to be reborn, it will surely perish.
You can explore new phenomena in the world, or look at old struggles in a new light.
As the events of the new game unfold, far, far away in Anazote, Sobrante is beginning his journey. Prince Geryon, however, has his own path of life and suffering. He shall learn that the powerful feel powerless, that to own the world is not to own yourself.
Our goal is to let the player feel like they wield the highest power and, at the same time, feel the inescapable binds of compromise when it comes to making important decisions. We want to summit a new creative peak, to go beyond our previous achievements. This new life and suffering game will be more complex and engaging. We have enhanced illustration quality, added more characters and plot threads, engaged with more poignant subjects.
Style of the new game carries over from the last, the life and suffering of Sobrante, like storybook illustrations. It is synthetic and somewhat eclectic, which is intentional. We weren't rebuilding from scratch, though we are creating an experience reminiscent of delving into an 18th century manuscript alongside the reader.
We approached game mechanics differently in the new game. It's more flexible, but it can still cut pretty deep. We also made it a little less linear. The game responds to player choice with incredible sensitivity. You will notice this when you make the same choice in different playthroughs. The way the world reacts to your actions will be distinctly different. The protagonist reigns supreme, and because of that position, every choice will have far-reaching ramifications. Geryon's choices will echo throughout the world. In the studio, we have an in-joke. We call our game a narrative strategy.
Last time, we chose the book as our main visual style reference, and we're sticking with it in the new game. The book lays bare the inner workings of the protagonist. He reevaluates his life and gets another read on it. He wonders if things could have been different, and we want the player to read the book with the protagonist. As a visual metaphor, we think it works really well for immersing the player in his memories and ruminations about choices made and roads untraveled.
Literature remains the through line in the new game. From a linguistic standpoint, we want to make the game plain and readable for the player, but at the same time, we want to preserve the beauty and refinement of the language. I hope our game style will fuel your imagination and delight even our most discerning readers.
We paint our game as a narrative RPG, but as we found our new hero, we felt compelled to make the genre deeper and richer. We felt we had to adapt the gameplay to accommodate our protagonist, the heir to the Empire. We had to add new elements, new mechanics, more story. The supreme power that Geryon wields as the Empire's monarch had to carry appropriate weight.
As I gaze into the eyes of the man they call Prince, I see not a ruler, but a puppet, a pawn, manipulated since birth by courtiers, friends, family, and even gods. Their admonitions pull me in all directions, tearing me apart, breaking me. I see a man who yearns for righteousness, but knows not who he must become. I will assert my power. My enemies will know my wrath. My resolve will never falter. My empire will prosper, and all those who stand in my way will be swept aside. I will be cautious and observant. I will plan meticulously, leveraging my connections. I will plot, scheme, and turn unsuspecting foes into friends. My courtiers will slit each other's throats to win my favor. I will listen to the people and heed their will. I will rule for their sake. I will strive for the greater good and the prosperity of all. I will cherish those I hold dear, guided by love and compassion. I will be the ruling hand of the gods. I will make their will manifest. And those who dare question my faith will draw their righteous ire. True believers will know love and bliss. My empire will become heaven on earth. And I will lead my flock to a brave new world. As I plumb the depths of my soul, I find a singular truth within. No matter the path I take, my life will be full of pain and suffering. Such is the fate of all rulers.
There are over 15 people working on the game in our studio right now, and all of them are working to enhance it in their own way. Every page in the life and suffering comes together with a part of the soul we put into it. You saw some team members in this little address we made, but we plan to introduce the rest of our studio as we continue to share more development details.
We're not making a AAA title. We're creating artistic expression. We love it, and we believe in it. I'm confident that we can deliver another fresh and original project that will generate player interest and become an exciting conversation piece. Log into Steam and add The Life and Suffering of Prince Jerry into your wish list now. This will help support us and help us along. We'll be very grateful for your help. Thank you so much, and see you later.
Gamesplay.org.